Wedding from Hell. Queen Esther warning after Meghan pulls last-minute nasty surprise. The big royal nuptials has turned into the wedding from hell, thanks to Prince Harry's famous fiancée. Queen Elizabeth II was forced to issue a dire warning to Meghan Markle, who decided to pull a last-minute nasty surprise which left the royal family stunned. You don't want to miss this. If you've been watching the craziness surrounding the royal wedding, what a difference 24 hours make. Meghan Markle's dad bowed out of walking her down the aisle, then he changed his mind, only to undergo heart surgery. Meghan's big mouth sister, Samantha Markle, reported that she broke her knee and ankle in a car accident caused by the paparazzi. The Hollywood tabloid TMZ, a favorite with Mr. Markle, posted a pic of Samantha in the emergency room. I am sure TMZ paid a pretty penny for that shot taken by her boyfriend Mark Phillips. After a few hours, the Daily Mail reported, cops are baffled by explosive claims that Meghan Markle's half-sister was run off the road and hospitalized by a paparazzo because they can't find any evidence the crash happened. Yeah, well, getting run off the road by rogue paparazzi hits pretty close to home for the royal family. We all know how Princess Diana died, so the story Samantha pumped to TMZ seemed far-fetched. Can you imagine the poor queen after all of this happening within 24 hours? Right before Samantha's so-called accident and after Meghan's father got out of surgery, the soon-to-be royal issued a statement about her father. It reads, "Sadly, my father will not be attending our wedding. I have always cared for my father and hope he can be given the space he needs to focus on his health." She adds, "I would like to thank everyone who has offered generous messages of support. Please know how much Harry and I look forward to sharing our special day with you on Saturday." Nice, she has always cared for her father. The good people of the United Kingdom were quite upset with her callous tone. Many pointed out, why not say, "I love my father and I am missing having him by my side on my wedding day," something warm that would prove she is not such a cold, calculating fish. This brings us to the wedding rehearsal. Remember, the royal family's survival is only possible due to the support of the British people. It is true that the royal family is rich, but it takes $368 million a year to run the monarchy, which means British taxpayers also support the royal family through a sovereign grant issued by the United Kingdom's Treasury. So when Meghan Markle decides to wear large dripping diamond earrings worth $10,000 for a wedding rehearsal, the Queen was fuming. Clearly, whoever is advising Miss Markle in the royal palace is either being ignored by her, or they aren't doing their job. But that's not all. Of course, Meghan's rich but not rich enough to drop a cool 10 grand on a pair of earrings. Immediately Page Six dedicated an entire article to this faux pas, as did the Mirror. Then, British top etiquette expert and friend to the Queen, William Hansen, issued a dire warning to Meghan, and she can take it to the bank that this is coming directly from the monarch herself. He warns the bride-to-be, if she starts ripping up the rulebook from day one, it is going to be a recipe for disaster. This is an institution that has been going on longer than any of us and will continue to do so. Meghan needs to remember she is a small cog in a very old machine. She has to remember it is not about her, it is about the causes she is going to be championing. Her own personal beliefs are irrelevant. Look, Hansen's warning is not over just the earrings. It was seen as a vulgar move for sure by the Queen, who is very cognizant of the royals not looking like Hollywood celebrities or rap stars dripping in diamonds and gold. There is a time and a place for wearing the big diamonds, a daytime wedding rehearsal isn't one of them. But also considering her own father's status, living in a Mexican hellhole surviving by eating chicken tacos and Diet Coke, the optics are crass. Which brings us to another issue, who is walking Meghan down the aisle? Well, first it was going to be her mom, Doria Ragland, but Meg's come up with a plan, which has her walking alone up the aisle, giving herself away. Now, Prince Charles will step in and walk part of the way with her. Meghan has no bridesmaids, no maid of honor. It is bizarre. William is Harry's best man. If they get through the wedding, the reception sounds simply horrific. If you're going to the wedding, bring your own food. Yep, This was another shocker for the Queen, who left the arrangements to be handled by Meghan and Harry. No doubt this was Meghan's choice, as Page Six reports, the royal wedding is going to be beef, bring your own food. Page Six has learned exclusively that not all of the 600 guests invited to Windsor grounds for Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding will be receiving catered food. Instead, they'll have to bring their own picnic baskets. And here's the kicker, those who will be allowed to eat will do so standing up eating bowl foods. Wow, this sounds more and more like a California barbecue by the pool. The reception fare is meant to be consumed standing up and will feature canapes and dishes served in small bowls, added Page Six. So, let's get this straight. Is the 92-year-old monarch is going to be standing around for hours picking food out of bowls? That mental image is a doozy. Lastly, we have one other tidbit to report that indeed says so much. Sari Vine, royal expert married to a conservative British politician, found out none of Prince Harry's close friends or cousins were invited. Why have Harry and Meghan invited a raft of celebrities at the expense of their own generation of young royals? This really is baffling. You invite people you must surely barely know, for instance, the Spice Girls, at the expense of childhood friends, wrote Vine in the Daily Mail. Vine lists Harry's childhood playmates who are also his cousins, like Freddie Windsor, 39, and his sister, Lady Gabriella Windsor, 37. None of Harry's mates from school or the military buddies got an invite, which is very unlike the friendly prince, but Meghan made sure that George Clooney will be there. Vine says, even the Duchess of Cambridge's sister, Pippa, has been frozen out of the evening do. Don't the couple want any real friends? Or do they just intend to spend their married life posing for selfies with Sir Elton John, who is invited? This is the royal wedding from hell. No wonder 66% of Britons polled said they will not be tuning in. Meghan Markle has shown her true colors to the Queen, who issued a royal smackdown. Get in line, or Harry's grandmother is coming for you, Meghan. You don't mess with the Queen.